Zaragon here. I have assimilated more than 17,000 albums from around the world in my 35 years as a music connoisseur. To explore the journey in depth, see the Trimax Music Database on RYM and the directory of Dutch bands on jazzrocksoul.com, both linked in the description below. While you're at it, hit the like and subscribe buttons and the bell and share this video. And follow me on Patreon and Twitch, where you can see me streaming and keep abreast of my writing and video activities. Now we are going to listen to a few tracks by three different Dutch bands circa 1970 at the forefront of the burgeoning European jazz rock scene. And the first of those is Ahura Mazda from their singular self-titled album with a very unique sound. This is the track Orange Ridgestad. Thank you. Okay, that was Ahura Mazda, and I almost got lost in that one. A lot of it sounded like echoey sounds in a tunnel. Like we start off with that really prominent kalimba that carries much of the early piece, and some whistly sounds. One of the guys here is credited. Peter Abink is credited with rattle among a bunch of sundries, and then Rob Van Wagengen plays kalimba that we heard. And amid the colliding sounds, reeds and such tins, we some bass lines took command at a few points in time. And as a matter of fact, as things got looser and kind of went through those corridors of echo and that bass line started to emerge from the others, and it got faster and faster and pulled things together toward the end. Yeah, but I like the pieces. They have a very unique sound. I mean, not many of these jazz rock jam bands were using kalimba at this point. In fact, not many people made the kalimba signature of their sound, aside from Earth, Wind, and Fire. They even named at least one track after it. Anyway, I'd like to play a part of another track, Spacey Tracy, but it's an 8.5 minute track. I want to cut like 3 minutes into where the instrumental section starts. Well, I'll just play the intro and then I'm going to jump forward here. Doesn't that sound kind of what would you call that? Kind of like Hawaiian rock or something? Island rock, tropical island. It has kind of a tropical flavor to it. Thank you. Spacey Tracy by Ahura Mazda, and we had quite a bit of warm, fuzzy guitar on that one, played by Peter Abink, and a lot of hyperactive percussion. Rob Van Wagenen is accredited with percussion among a number of sundries, but the drummer is Winky Abink. And once again, the bass was often emerging. Oh, Tony Schroeder, the bassist who's also credited with percussion, the bass would often kind of emerge and just sort of pull things together with these lines. It would be subtle at times, it would be kind of in the background, but it would emerge and things would form kind of a gravity center for of all the colliding, windy. Oftentimes, it was just everything else was just kind of like a hurricane of windy sounds and metals and such. Yeah, and kind of dust, kicking up dust at times. Yeah, that was Spacey Tracy. Well, the bulk of it, the instrumental portion anyway, from Ahura Mazda. And doesn't seem like these musicians really did much beyond this. A quick check of Discogs, anyway, I would say. Anyway, now on to another Dutch band who premiered in 1970 and went on to put out about five albums. And this is the first of them. I'm talking about Super Sister with the track Memories Are New.
I cigarette, blow my mind and fill my head. You left me to change, told me I felt strange. You're clever, try to live in the blaze. There's no need to retrace. Light my things, I cigarette, blow my mind and fill my head. A cigarette, blow your mind and fill your head. Thank you.
Okay, that was In the Mold of Soft Machine Volume 2, right down to the fuzz bass work of Ron Van Eck. Yes, very much inspired by Hugh Hopper there, those fuzzy runs. Some of them hitting some real high fretboards for a bass. And I believe some organ filtered through similar pedals, played by Robert Jan Stips. And some really kinetic drumming there by Marco Vrolik. Time signatures were really snappy and alternating like bars of four with like, oh, like eight, five, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, like that. Yeah. Yeah. 8, 4, 4, 3, 2, like. And or like 8 and 5, 8, 5, like that, really fast. Probably some other odd meters thrown in there amongst things, and just a really snappy, energetic feel, just full of fuzzy sounds coming in here and there, like rapturous noises. Yeah, just in a field occupied by very few. Yeah, not many people took after that period of Soft Machine, even if it's one of the most well-loved periods of the band. I mean, there were these guys, and then like a year later, the French band Moving Gelatin Plates were the foremost bands to purvey the Soft Machine Volume 2 style. Let's hear another sequence of tracks from the debut album Present from Nancy, from the Metamorphosis Suite, Mexico.
Initiation, waiting for the decadence to brave, waiting to be strong for the departure, waiting to be killed beyond the way. We'll be right back.
Okay, and that was Super Sister with two parts of their Metamorphosis suite, Mexico and Metamorphosis. Now, Mexico had that real like open cadence, echoey drumming, and mid-paced, some more traditional organ sound, clean bass, and some soft vibraphone on certain notes, under some layers there, just kind of echoing. A real contrast to the other pieces that we heard by them in the set. And then Metamorphosis goes in this like really persistent downbeat with really gruff distorted organ, sputtering at times, fuzz bass. That same like kinetic frenetic style of theirs, almost like proto-punk in that one, or post-punk there, yeah. Super Sister with four cuts or really selections from two of the suites off of Present for Nancy, which all the tracks kind of run together. It's on that one. Just like on Soft Machine Volume 2, actually. Super Sister with chunks of their suites, Memories Are New and Metamorphosis from Present from Nancy. And at the top of the set, two tracks from the singular album by Ahura Mazda. Setting the 70s off to a bang, three very innovative and unique bands from the Dutch scene, which would start to really fill up in the coming years with bands like Golden Earring, Kayak, Alcuin, and Solution, Earth and Fire, and many more. And let's see, a few weeks ago, about a month ago, I covered some of the other Dutch bands, like Machine, Mr. Albert Show, and Earth and Fire in another three bundle video like this. Go see that one. For more Rubies and Sapphires from the catalog of Exception, Super Sister, and Ahura Mazda, see the directory of albums by Dutch artists linked in the description below for Red Hot Tracks and Purples from the catalogs of all those artists, as well as the other ones I mentioned, Earth and Fire, Golden Earring, Kayak, Alcuin. Goes on and on and on. Like and subscribe, follow me on social media, share the video, and leave a comment if there are any observations you have about the the numerous tracks we just heard. I lost count. There's like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Technically, we heard 10 titles in that set, even if several of them were linked in pairs. And anyway, the interplay, the intensity, the soloing, the sound effects, the rupturous nature, the free form nature, the eclectic instrumentation involved, the lyrics on the numbers that have them anyway, if anything struck you about those. And check out my Twitch channel where I am streaming my listening and writing activities, and join me on Patreon for more insider exclusives on my writing and video content creation. And until next time, this is Aragon, the world's most ear travel trimaximalist, signing off.